Yo, what's going on, night family? Welcome back to another video, guys. Welcome back to another vlog. And hey, dude, today is the day where your boy get his hair fixed up, shaped up, washed, and braided. So today's gonna be a good day, man. So I'm gonna do some Instacart. It's about like a 7:30 right here, 7:39, 7:40-ish. Running a little late as I don't want to. Today is a rainy day, so your boy got the sweatshirt, not sweatshirt, but hoodie on, sweatpants on, of course. All black, dude. Shit. Yeah. Go ahead and fix the hair. Eat some breakfast. And get up out of here, baby. So let's get this day started. Let's go. So, I just accepted a quick little $12 order. It's not the best. This is it right here. 19 items. $12. It's a mile away. Just to get something started, you know. That's the car being acting weird. So, yeah. Accepting whatever, you know. And I'm always up here at the Taste Creek Kroger. If you guys ever see me at Taste Creek Kroger, stop by and say what's up to the boy D-Night. You already know. Hey, dude, let's go ahead and get up in here shopping. Got a hair appointment at 12:30. Get the hair washed. Get a little hot oil treatment. You know, I got to take care of the hair. And get it braided later today. Get the sides faded up because my hair is looking rough. And it's a rainy day. So, hey, I'm not looking the best on a rainy day. Let's hit start shopping anyway. I'm shopping at this grocery store. I'm glad that Instacart got that feature that we can shop at close grocery stores unless it tells us that we have to shop at that particular grocery store. Hey, dude. 8 o'clock in the morning. Raining. And, hey, dude, get this shit started. Beautiful, empty store. That's how I like it when I do my grocery shopping. It's empty. Best feeling ever. So, 19 items. Everybody, well, first customer I had did not want vegetables. It's like almost every customer I get want vegetables. Goddamn, they want something from the deli. I hate when they do this right here because it takes up some of my time. It takes about like 5 to 10 minutes before them to cut it up. And if there's a line, take even longer. So that it gets annoying. So let me go ahead and put this down, knock this order out the way. Let's get going. All right, so I knocked out 3 orders. Made $52. Got some Oreo. Got this little peanut butter pie thing right here. Pretty good, you know. First time having it, freaking sliding off my damn armrest. But hey, I moved my haircut appointment. Well, hair appointment, I moved that back to 2 o'clock so I can do more orders. Knock those out the way. Once I'm finished with my hair appointment, then I'm going home, chill, relax, enjoy the rest of my day. Yeah. So, hey, do I catch you guys when I'm at my haircut appointment? I'm tired. I just feel like closing my eyes and just falling asleep, bro. Like, honestly, yeah. All right, guys, so your boy made $61 today. Did crappy on Instacart, you know? So, hey, let's go ahead and get up in this spot where I'm about to go get my hair did. Back for more. Yeah, boy, back for some more, you know? So, all I'm gonna try to do is get a hot oil treatment, see how that is, get my sides faded up. Your boy can look good, get my hair braided today. Things like that. So, yeah, man. Boy dressed appropriate for the weather. Got a Wisconsin hoodie on. Also, got some joggers on, well, sweatpants on, things like that. So, hey, let's go and get up in here. They're already looking at me. Yep. I like them pants. Got the flower pants going on.
Thank you. It's actually like a monkey. It's like a
jumpsuit. Really?
Thank you. Just the size, just a little high skin fade.
Gotcha. Okay, so maybe need to come back in.
Probably should have brought my pick.
I got a pick.
Okay.
This should make a huge difference for your scalp.
Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. Because, like, I wash my hair, like, once a week. And when it comes to the time to wash it, I was like a lot of dandruff started to show.
Yeah.
If I scratch my hair or something.
Yeah. It's usually when you know it's time. Mm-hmm. Get all that dead skin out of there. Yeah. And this oil that we used, it of course is a good heavy dose of moisture for your scalp, but it also like regulates the pH of your hair and your scalp. Mm-hmm. So if it's dry due to an imbalance of some sort, then that will kind of get everything back to normal, like where it should be.
So awesome.
Christmas plans yet?
Oh man, might go back home. Might, depends on what my dad doing.
Like Mississippi home?
Yeah.
Do you get to go back a lot?
A little bit, sometimes here and there.
That's good.
But I'm definitely gonna go back on his birthday. His birthday is like December the 15th.
Oh, your dad's?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm gonna go back and see him, see what's up.
That's like next week, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. You gotta get prepared for that drive.
Yeah, seriously.
What about you?
We usually just go to my grandma's. Nothing too crazy.
Yeah.
We're a really small family. There's just like 7 of us, I think.
Really?
So, yeah, it's never anything like a big production or anything. We always do the same thing for every holiday, just go to my grandma's and try and keep her seated.
And that little spot is in Memphis, Tennessee too. It's like, for some reason, Memphis and Jackson, Mississippi always got this little theme for the court system. It's weird.
Really? That's weird.
Yeah.
Like they like scratch each other's back, so to speak.
That's what it's basically like.
Yeah.
Like Jackson is like a smaller version of Memphis.
Mm.
It's ghetto and wild.
It's ghetto, is that easy?
Yeah, it's ghetto and wild.
Yeah. So, I actually want to go. I would love to go to Memphis.
I bet you would.
It would be so fun. I almost went at one point in time just to go. I don't remember what happened, why we didn't go.
You need to go to a basketball game over there.
A basketball game?
Yeah, it's pretty dope.
Yeah.
go down Beale Street, downtown area, go to the bars. They got blues, jazz, type stuff like that.
Yes, that's where I want to go for that and the food, of course.
Yeah, they got good barbecue there.
I've heard, yeah.
The southern, that real southern life, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it'll probably make Kentucky look like nothing.
It will. I'll say like deep south. I'll say New Orleans, Memphis, Jackson, of course, Alabama, and Atlanta, Georgia. Those are like...
Mm-hmm. Like the deep.
Yeah, deep south cities, yeah. Right there. Where you can find some real Cajun, also southern
yeah.
food.
Yeah. Yeah, like it's a different kind of south. Like I feel like Kentucky is like...
Like mid-south, that's what they like to call
like
it.
It's like redneck south.
I'd like, say more like hillbilly south.
Yes.
Redneck
yeah,
is Mississippi. It's a different type of lifestyle, you know? Like
really?
Yeah, I learned that from having redneck and hillbilly friends. They said redneck and hillbilly ain't the same.
No, I always thought they would be the same.
Nah.
Have you ever been to Eastern Kentucky?
Yeah, I've been near West Virginia with a friend. He has a family that lives far east, like it's like a house. The house was like a barn and it's on a mountain.
And is it in a holler?
Yeah, basically what it is, has an upstairs, downstairs,
mm-hmm.
seen like writing on the wall. It's like, damn, yeah. Who put graffiti on you guys' walls? And they were so nice. And
they are nice. I'll give them that.
I went in there, looked like they were eating off
they're
of three
different hospitals.
Yeah, they're really cool. I like them. We went hunting out there in West Virginia 2 years ago when I first moved out here.
Oh my God, you cannot pay me enough. Well, I used to say that about going to Eastern Kentucky, but I practically lived there for like 4 years, so.
Yeah, I'm from Mississippi, and I've been through all through Mississippi, the swamps, the Delta,
mm-hmm.
all kinds of things. I probably met some racist people, but I've never had any racial encounters or anything like
really?
That.
Really?
Yeah, and I've been like to the neck of the woods,
yeah.
bonfires with rednecks.
That's crazy. I mean,
never experienced it. It's crazy.
I will say, like, I expected a lot more racial encounters in Eastern Kentucky than I
yeah.
actually had. Like, there were, like, maybe a handful of times that someone would, like, say something offensive in front of me or something, but
man,
9 times out of 10, like, they would catch themselves, because they just aren't used to being around black people.
Damn.
So they would just say it, and then they'd catch themselves and be like, oh my God, I'm sorry, and, like, they would apologize up and down and sideways and everything. There was one time went to, we had gone to some guy's house, like, one of my friend's boyfriends or something along those lines. I didn't know the dude. So, he needed a ride. That's what it was. So we went and picked him up and then took him to his house and he invited us inside. So we came inside.
Mm-hmm.
His entire living room was like a KKK shrine. Like, it was the most uncomfortable thing I've ever experienced. And, like, he did not acknowledge them. Like, didn't be like, oh, don't mind my KKK memorabilia, like nothing.
I bet he was like, it's okay, you wanted
so
a good
weird.
One.
Right, yeah, that's probably what he thought. Like, yeah, she's brown, but she's nice. She's cool, we like her.
Come to our Klan rally.
Yeah.
Let's go.
She can be our spokesperson.
Have you seen Boondocks?
No.
And they got
I've seen here and there, yeah.
Uncle Ruckus was going to the Klan meetings with Robert, it's a racist guy, famous racist man.
Yeah.
And he was like, you're different. I like you. And they started becoming friends. They started becoming friends, and all the KKK people started hating on the dude and kicked him out.
God.
Kicked him out the Klan because he made friends with a black guy.
That's hilarious. Oh my God.
It's so funny to this day.
I used to watch it with my dad, like here and there. I couldn't tell you any of the characters, like names or anything. But.
I'm pretty sure you know Huey, the guy with the afro.
Yeah, the little teeny tiny.
Uh huh.
Yeah.
And you got Riley with the braid. Granddad.
Yeah, I know that one. That's the one that you sound like.
Granddad.
You just like.
mm-hmm. My favorite guy is Uncle Ruck. Is like that dude. Mm.
Which one's that?
The racist black guy.
Oh, okay.
Right there.
Hell no. Oh my God, that's so funny.
She can't be that cute, she's black. I've
always wanted to. That's exactly what they'd be saying too.
That's
if
funny.
I had a quarter. time I heard, "You're so pretty for a black girl."
Yeah.
I'd be like,
thank you. Well, I love that show. I had one of my friends watch it. And he was like, "Dude, what the hell is this?" His favorite part was the exorcism when Uncle Ruckus was performing the exorcism on Tom.
Yeah.
And it was like removing an evil Negro spirit from a Negro. It's like removing stink from a hunk of shit.
Oh my God.
He lost his shit when he heard that.
I cannot. So funny. Thinking back, why did my dad watch that with me when I was like little?
I don't know. Same reason why kids play Grand Theft Auto.
True. Touche. Because I was right there too. Beating up the hookers and stealing cars.
Oh God, beating up the hookers.
I keep forgetting this. How did you feel about the line last time? Did you like it? Did you not like it?
Oh yeah, I
like
it.
You liked it? Okay.
Yeah, it was dope.
Do you want me to do it again?
Yeah, let's do it again. It added a little swagger.
Yeah,
scene.
Yeah.
I forgot you had a customer here. I was going crazy. Kids, how's your wife?
Not everybody.
I always
like your.
That's
a
word.
Right. No,
that's not a word. Where you said waffle? Love, I'm not sure. You're amazing.
You're awesome. I try.
What you guys think, man? She awesome. Send some clients her way. If I got some people. If you want to leave your barber, she's definitely worth it.
I hope so.
Damn, bro. I'm going to wear my hair in a fro. But it's like, it's going into some braids, baby.
Well, at least it'll look good until you get your braids in.
Yeah.
And your scalp will be nice and moisturized and whatnot.
Yeah, that's what I need. My mom can't say something about it no more.
Gotta keep mom happy.
Mm-hmm.
Keep you happy.
Thanks.
You are very welcome. How are you on your product? Are you liking it?
Oh, yeah, I'm loving it. I use it like almost every day.
Yeah.
Good, in my hair when I wake up. Put some water in my hair and use it.
Do you like spray the water in? Or do you just like scrunch it?
I grab it in my hands, rub my hands together, and do it like that.
Of course you do.
Typical guy, huh?
Yes, a very typical guy. I mean, it works. I can't fault you for it.
Yo, hey, yo. Ouch, my fingers. What you guys think? Got the portrait video mode going on. Is the hair looking healthy? Yes, it is. All right, transfer some money.
Let's go. Make this payment.
It does work.
It does.
Right? Okay, well, yeah, I'm
here. Alright, so we're just gonna stand here. I'm gonna be like, think of what I'm gonna say. Lay, breathe back for more. Make sure I get the card out.
Shine
it to the camera.
Yeah. My Instagram name is the Hair Fairy.
Shout
that out.
I will. All right. You ready?
I guess.
All right. So, hey, it's my stylist right here, Bree. She hooked me up. She the reason why I stay stiffy like this, looking good. That's one thing she does. You guys come shout her out. Well, I'm shouting her out. Come check her out right here. Back for more. She's over here on Heartland by the Kroger's over here. It's a little shopping complex. So, go check her out. It's a cool person. She's awesome. She's very friendly.
That's right.
Awesome person. So, hey, check her out, guys.
Yay. Instagram is the Hair Fairy.
Yeah. Link's down in the description. Also, it's on the screen somewhere around here somewhere.
Right here. Down here.
Yeah, we got it.
Over there.
Let's get in. Yeah. Hey y'all, what do you guys think about the hair, man? The hair looking fresh to death. You can suck my nuts looking ass, boy. Feeling good. Feeling amazing, dude. Bree always hooked me up when I come over there, bro. She really replaced my barber. I had a guy, you know, Kim Lee, as you guys are OG subscribers. Hey, Kim Lee, I'm sorry, my boy. I'm sorry. She does a good job. She washes my hair. She takes care of it. She makes sure the hair is healthy and nice. So that's one thing I like to go to a salon when you're getting your hair done. So me, I'm a person who's trying to grow my hair out, get it longer. So a regular barber is something that's not, I need more of a salon. So I'm up here at Kroger's, about to get something to eat, man. I'll stop doing Instacart right now. Didn't make that much money on Instacart. Made about, what, $80-some? Ain't much. But hey, I'm gonna do a little shopping, buy some bread, buy a little something here and there. I'm gonna be ending this video pretty soon. I have to get my hair braided. I am gonna get my hair braided. That's one thing about me. So can't walk around with a fro too much, man. I like to braid, you know, Brady Knight in the building, you know? That's one thing I like to do. So I'm gonna grab some bread, milk, cereal, some juice. Hey, let's get it. That's all I got right here, guys. I was thinking about some more stuff, but then again, I was like, don't need much. Got a bag of hot chips. Got some cereal, got the almond kind, some milk, bread, and some jelly. So, that's about all I'm gonna do today. Go home, chill and relax, get my hair braided. That's one thing I'm gonna do. Get my hair braided, and that's about it. I should have went to that lane over there, but it is what it is. Let's get up out of here. All right, Night Fan, about to wrap up today's vlog. Got the hair braided. Looking good, feeling fresh after the wash. And hey, dude, shout out to my girl Bree for helping me out, making me look good, making the hair look good, keeping me in the game, keeping me fresh to death, you know? Hey, dude, if you guys enjoyed today's video, thumbs it up, subscribe to the channel, want to see more videos from me, of course. About to work out while I'm uploading this video. I already got most of it edited. I just need to put this part in, and bing, bada, boom. If you guys want to see more long videos like this, this video is probably like 23, 24 minutes long. I'm not sure. If you guys prefer me to keep 10 to 15 minutes or make longer videos or like a mix, let me know. Hey, let me know, man. I'm enjoying putting this content out. If I do something, I want to vlog it, give you guys the content that you deserve. And hey, man, like, subscribe if you're new. Share the video around the world, find it entertaining. Love you guys. Out. Peace.